Ah, remember the days of the Opel Corsa light? Well, it feels like it's been an age. Probably because it has been. In 1994, we saw the first Corsa arrive in South Africa. And since then, more than 180,000 have been sold.
When you consider it sits side by side with the likes of the Volkswagen Polo and Ford Fiesta, that is no small feat. A quick search on Gumtree and you'll get the average price of a Corsa as far back as 2015.
We now get to enjoy the sixth generation Corsa here in South Africa, and it offers something that its rivals don't, and that's a more powerful engine. But more on that later. What you might want to know is the fact that this is sort of, or essentially actually, a Peugeot 208. The reason being is that the Stellantis group, which has the MP1 platform, is what underpins this, as well as the 208, the 208, and in fact the Opel Mokko as well.
But let's kick off here with the styling. Needless to say, it doesn't exactly stand out in a crowd. This might be the reason it hasn't enjoyed the same popularity as some of its rivals. With that said, Opel has tried to make it a bit more attractive with its wing-shaped LED lights and forward-sloping C-pillars. There are a few highlights to the exterior, but it might need a bit more work to be a more attractive offering. This is the top-of-the-range elegance model, but you can still opt for two other models if your budget doesn't stretch to this range topper. Opel doesn't skimp on features, and standard on this is a 7-inch touchscreen infotainment system with Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, a multi-function steering wheel which has a rim wrapped in leather, cruise control, and Bluetooth connectivity. This elegance model adds heated front seats, front and rear park distance control, climate control air conditioning, rain-sensing wipers, and partial cloth and leather upholstery. As much as the features list is pretty impressive, the overall look and feel of the interior is somewhat like the exterior, which means it's a bit bland. In other words, it might not excite you. The digital instrument cluster is also rather odd. Many have mentioned that it looks like it was stuck on after the car was designed. For a range-topping model, this is rather disappointing. Overall, it feels like Opel may have skimped on too many things in here. But when it comes to safety, Opel redeems itself somewhat. There is a 180-degree reverse view camera, lane keeping assist, traffic sign recognition, forward collision alert, front pedestrian detection, and collision mitigation braking. A total of 6 airbags is fitted, along with ABS with EBD and electronic stability control with traction control. So the Corsa is forgiven its boring interior, I think.
So I mentioned the engine earlier. This elegance has a 1.2-litre turbo petrol under the bonnet, and it gives you 96 kilowatts of power and 230 Nm of torque, which is quite a bit more than its rivals. For example, the equivalent Polo 1-litre turbo only gets you 85 kilowatts of power and 200 Nm of torque, and the Fiesta is even less. This is mated to a 6-speed automatic transmission. There's a tiny bit of turbo lag that might be bothersome when you push hard, but I think you'll get used to it, and it is quite expected. And fuel consumption is sitting at 6.3 litres per 100 Ks. Overall, it is a very punchy engine and one that I think most people will enjoy living with on a day-to-day basis. There are many positives about the Opel Corsa, but there are quite a few negatives as well. But even with most of the negatives, it's still a worthy contender in its segment.
And if you're bored of the top game players, then get onto Gumtree and check out some great deals on the Corsa, because you'll certainly find one that will suit your budget.